Hi, good afternoon, friends. We have Yash Chaudhary, rank 6, and Arpit Singhal, who has to speak about preparation and strategies associated with that. Let's start by a brief introduction of yourself.
So, I come from a village in Amroha district of Uttar Pradesh. I've done my schooling from Amroha itself. Then I pursued my major in civil engineering and minor in product design from IIT Guwahati. And after that, I have been preparing for civil services. And this was my third attempt. I could not clear my prelims in my first attempt. Then I reached till the interview stage in my second attempt, but failed to make it to the final list. And this was my third attempt.
You're the first civil servant from the family?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that is a big thing.
Yes.
Arpit?
I am Arpit Singhal. I come from Shamli district of Uttar Pradesh. I did my graduation from IIT Delhi with a B.Tech degree in 2018.
B.Tech in
Mathematics and Computing. This was my fourth attempt. Mm-hmm. I failed the first two prelims. Last year, I got All India rank 239 and I got into IPS. This year, I got All India rank 53.
Okay. I'll start with something like, where were you when the results came? What was your first reaction?
When the result came, I was at my home.
Okay.
And one of my friend called me and told me that I got rank 6. I was not expecting such a...
And this is the second time you're searching for your name in the rank list.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
So it was, what was it? Shock, surprise, relief?
It was a surprise and after that a sigh of relief.
Right.
Yes. Because I was not expecting this good rank.
You don't have to read Hindu and Indian Express anymore.
Yes. Yes.
Right. Arpit, where were you when the results came?
I was also at my home.
Right.
So while I saw the list, my parents were sitting, my brother, my sister were sitting with me. So generally, I start from the first rank to see
right.
my rank.
Right. That's good confidence.
Yes. So I tell them I am not till 30. I am not till this rank. Then I saw my name at 53 rank.
53. Right.
So most of my family members cried.
Right.
I also shouted a lot after right. seeing my name right. because finally the UPSC journey, CLL services
so,
journey.
How ended. Was it? Last year also you saw your name in the results.
Yes, yes.
So how was this different from last year?
This was last year, it was more about getting a rank,
right.
finding the name in the list. This time the competition was tough because right. I had to get a good rank to upgrade myself from.
You have to get under 60, 50, 60 ranks.
Under 70, under 75. 70.
Right.
So that was a major sigh of relief because this cycle of UPSC, CSC will was
come
over
an,
that day.
Come to an end.
Yes.
Right. Now this struggle is over.
Yes.
Other struggles will start yes. in life. So I'll take it structure wise from the various stages of the preparation. Considering both of you have failed the prelims in different years, what worked for you in prelims in the years when it cleared?
Actually, I'm not sure about this because I have used the same strategy in my all three attempts.
So even when the year when you did not clear also, it was a strategy was
yes,
same?
Yes, yes. It was right. almost the same strategy.
So did you clear by a margin or it was just...
No, in my first attempt, I failed by 6 marks.
Okay.
In my second and third attempt, it was a good score. Even I cleared the Forest Service,
Cutoff.
Cutoff
right.
also.
Right.
Yes.
And for you?
For me, in the prelims, I had a strategy. Because first time I gave just to test myself. My second attempt was a major attempt, but I failed by 16 marks.
16 marks.
Yes.
Okay.
The third time, I qualified the Forest also, Forest Cutoff. The change was primarily that I thought that prelims is primarily a knowledge game.
Okay.
But it is a knowledge game, but there is also some use of common sense.
And techniques.
Techniques and wider understanding of the topics. And while attempting the paper, it is about solving those 100 questions.
Right.
So I worked on my temperament. I worked on my use of common sense. I enhanced my broader knowledge so that I can eliminate options.
So it's not purely an intellectual exercise. It is also about other factors.
Other factors, definitely.
Right. Because we have come across students who clear prelims by just studying for 15 days, right?
Yes.
Even this year, interview results came last week and there will be a lot of people who will clear despite of getting yes. only 1 week.
Yes.
And at the same time, we have students who have been studying for years who are unable to crack prelims. So this is with respect to prelims. You did any test series or test solving for prelims?
I did a lot of tests for prelims.
Right.
This attempt I couldn't do because the result and prelims was very close enough.
Right.
But last year I used to solve the prelims test series.
Do you have a number, 40 tests, 50 tests?
I think at the start you need to know yourself because sometimes it might happen that within the first test you are scoring good. But someone might be getting 50 marks in the first test. So if you have to improve, you can find an increase if you do give more tests.
Okay.
Yes.
So each test is a opportunity to improve and try something new.
Definitely.
For you, how many tests do you usually give for prelims?
Actually, in my first attempt, I gave around 40-50 tests.
Okay.
In my second attempt, I gave around 10 to 15 tests, and I did not take any test in my third attempt.
Okay.
Yes.
So I remember while we were speaking, you said, you know, I don't have a strategy for prelims. Don't want to guide anyone for prelims.
Yes.
Right. Prelims is unexpected. I think it changes. This year also, if you look at the paper, have you seen the paper?
Yeah, I have seen the paper.
They have changed some new type of questions.
Definitely.
And things like that. Prelims, do you make notes for prelims?
Actually, I have made notes for all the books that I have referred to.
Okay.
I have made notes from Spectrum also, from Lakshmikant also, from basic NCRTs, for example, for art and culture. So whatever I have read, I have made notes out
so
of
it's concise.
Yes, it was more focused on prelims part. For example, from the Lakshmikant, I have made notes from the prelims perspective itself, not from the mains perspective.
How do you differentiate? Let's take a topic like Panchayati Raj.
Mm-hmm.
How would your prelims notes and mains notes be different?
So prelims notes mein kya hota hai ki hum bahut zyada jo factual cheeze hoti hain hum usko likhte hain, jaise ki कौन से आर्टिकल में आता है, शेड्यूल में कौन से में आता है, क्या प्रोविजंस हैं उसके. बट जब हम मेंस के नोट्स बनाते हैं, फिर हम उसमें ये लिखते हैं कि क्या प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, क्या कमिटीज़ की रिकमेंडेशंस हैं, सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने क्या बोला है, इस चीज़ को कैसे सॉल्व किया जाए. सो दीज सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग्स आर इंक्लूडेड इन द
वन इज वेरी फैक्चुअल इन नेचर एंड अदर इज मोर कॉन्सेप्चुअल इन नेचर.
यस यस ट्रू.
राइट. सो डू यू हैव लाइक वी हैव सीन वेरियस टॉपर्स ओवर द इयर्स हु हैव वेरी क्रिस्प नोट्स एंड शॉर्ट नोट्स.
यस.
क्रिस्प नोट्स इज जस्ट अ कलेक्शन ऑफ डाटा. Do you have something like that also?
No, my notes were very expensive.
Very expensive.
Yes.
Right. But how many times were you able to revise with your notes?
Actually, most of the times to main books hi padhta tha. But exam se pehle main apne notes pe zyada focus karta tha. Usko main kai baar padh leta tha.
Okay.
Jaise mera optional sociology hai, uska hi maine extensive notes banaye. Aur GS aur sociology ke beech mein maine sirf notes ko revise kiya. To exam se pehle main notes karta tha, baaki time to main books hi padhta tha.
Okay. And for you, how are the notes?
I think similarly. I even made notes from the Lakshmikant because I have around 90 to 95 pages notes.
No, Lakshmikant itself is around 500 pages.
Yes,
you can't revise that.
Yes.
So I made primarily, this is the thing that I did, that I made separate note for prelims and separate for mains. I think he has added to all the points. The benefit of that is whenever you come across something new, you can add that to your notes.
Okay.
And it becomes easier for you to revise again and again, again and again. So I think that is beneficial.
Okay.
I even made concise notes from Shankar IAS because if you see that book, there will be less portion on prelims part, more on conceptual understanding. So if you can take that out, so it would save your time.
Now, one common thing we find among people who score secure good ranks is that they have good notes. I think
yes.
Notes is a very integral part. And the challenge is that when you make it, it's very time consuming, but after that, it's very useful when you are preparing for the examination.
Sir, I think it is more efficient to make notes because you feel that it is time consuming. But the most things that you learn, it is during the note making process. Because
you
that
research.
Is, you research, that is an active learning. You try to make subsections where things will fall. So that will make your understanding better. So I think it is a very good thing to make notes.
Okay. So you have notes for both prelims and mains?
Mains, different, definitely.
Different. So subject-wise, topic-wise, difference between current affairs, conceptual, how is it?
I think, I personally feel that UPSC has less focus on current affairs. They focus on contemporary issues definitely, but factually current affairs, they don't focus much. It is more about understanding and the things that are static in portion.
I have an opinion here. I feel that, you know, they'll ask a conceptual question from an issue which is in contemporary.
Definitely, news. Definitely.
So the relevance is from contemporary, but the question is conceptual
exactly.
In nature.
Yes.
Right. So prelims, I think we have talked about notes. We have talked about test solving. What else? How has prelims papers changed since the last 2-3 years from the first attempt to now?
Actually, I think jo pattern hai wo thoda thoda change ho raha hai. अभी थोड़ी सी रैंडमनेस मुझे ज़्यादा लगती है पहले से, और क्वेश्चंस कुछ एरियाज़ में वो एकदम अनएक्सपेक्टेड आ रहे हैं. जैसे इस बार आईआर के क्वेश्चंस आ गए हैं, लास्ट टू लास्ट ईयर एग्रीकल्चर के क्वेश्चंस आ गए थे, लास्ट ईयर स्पोर्ट्स के क्वेश्चंस आ गए थे. तो थोड़ी जो रैंडमनेस है वो बढ़ गई है मुझे लगता है.
इवन इन मेंस दैट S-400 मिसाइल सिस्टम क्वेश्चन हैड कम, दैट वाज वेरी अनप्रेडिक्टेबल. सो how do you strategize for an exam which is getting more and more random?
मेरे perspective या मेरी opinion के हिसाब से तो हमको understanding पे ज़्यादा ध्यान देना चाहिए. जैसे अर्पित ने बोला कि static part बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है, prelims के लिए भी बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है. अगर हम उसको बहुत ज़्यादा अंडरस्टैंडिंग और कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी के साथ पढ़ें तो क्वेश्चन किसी भी तरह का आ जाए हम उसको टैकल कर सकते हैं. हम चीज़ों को इंटरकनेक्ट कर सकते हैं कि पॉलिटी में कहीं कुछ पढ़ा है, थोड़ा रिकॉल हो जाता है, इंटरकनेक्ट कर देते हैं एक सब्जेक्ट को दूसरे सब्जेक्ट को, दूसरे सब्जेक्ट से पॉलिटी को जियोग्राफी से, इस तरह से इंटरकनेक्ट कर सकते हैं अगर हमारी अंडरस्टैंडिंग होती है तो. और जो स्टैटिक के क्वेश्चन है आई थिंक उसमें 100 मार्क्स तो लाए जा सकते हैं जिससे कि प्रीलिम्स का कट ऑफ क्लियर हो जाएगा. तो मेरे हिसाब से तो अंडरस्टैंडिंग बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी
है. रॉट लर्निंग विल नॉट वर्क, कॉन्सेप्चुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग होना चाहिए
क्योंकि फैक्चुअल पूछते नहीं है प्रीलिम्स में, बहुत कम क्वेश्चंस फैक्चुअल होते हैं.
आई टेल स्टूडेंट्स दैट यू नो प्रीलिम्स इज डिजाइन टू एलिमिनेट, सेलेक्ट करने के लिए नहीं, एलिमिनेट करने के लिए एग्जाम डिजाइन किया हुआ. सो दैट इज समथिंग. नाउ आई थिंक लास्ट 3 इयर्स अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट चेंज इन प्रीलिम्स इज सीसैट एग्जाम. इट्स गेटिंग टफर एंड टफर इवन दिस ईयर. And I think when the marks were released this year for the exam, a lot of people have stayed back because of CSAT and not because of GS.
Yes.
Now, I'm assuming both of you are from IIT, so I don't think you have a separate preparation for CSAT. Was it the case or do you separately practice for CSAT?
Actually, I have attempted few tests from the previous years. Apart from that, I have not prepared for CSAT. But I have observed that ki abhi jo English aa raha hai, वो पहले से थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट हो गया. उसके जो ऑप्शन है थोड़े वो सेम से लगते हैं और जो मैथ्स है उसमें भी जो बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग है उसको ज़्यादा टेस्ट कर रहे हैं आजकल. पहले जो फॉर्मूलेज लग जाते थे वो फॉर्मूलेज का लगना अभी मेरे हिसाब से बंद हो गया है. ये मेरा
इंग्लिश इज अनप्रेडिक्टेबल इवन जब व्हेन यू लुक एट द कीज़ नो एवरी इंस्टीट्यूट डिफर्स इन ओपिनियन ऑन इंग्लिश सॉल्यूशन एंड मैथ्स इज कंपैरेटिवली मोर प्रेडिक्टेबल कंपेयर टू इंग्लिश. हाउ इज सीसैट फॉर यू?
I have never studied for CSAT. Yes, but for people who are appearing for prelims, I would suggest them, please don't waste your entire preparation just because of CSAT. I think a person is intellectual enough. The problem is you have to let go of that fear and you have to focus more on maths part, because I have friends who have done their graduation in English literature. But they are also finding it difficult to solve the English part. So I think they should focus on basic maths and please do that way before prelims and ensure that you are getting at least 80 to 90 marks, and it is a humble request to everyone.
And another thing that I am seeing is that passages are one page and one question from that.
Exactly.
So the amount of time you take to read the passage itself is so much.
Yes.
So whoever starts with English, they are stuck in English. And then they realize they have 30 minutes and math to solve.
Yes.
So time management is also a factor.
Definitely.
Right. And it's slowly moving towards that CAT kind of
Exactly. They have increased the difficulty.
Right.
Because I remember during my first attempt, I got more than 170 marks in CSAT.
Mm.
It reduced by 30 to 40 marks next year.
When we used to give the exam, CSAT was, you just needed marks in CSAT.
Yes,
so it
yes.
was a cumulative score.
Yes, yes.
So we had candidates who had 180 marks in CSAT and 50 marks in GS.
Yes,
still they'll clear.
Yes.
I've even met people who decided which optional to choose after the prelims results.
Mm-hmm.
Because they never thought that, you know, they were going to clear this. Right. So this is with respect to prelims.
But I would like to add something. Right. As you have said that randomness increased, I think we have to go back to the basics.
Hmm.
We have to ensure that we are able to do those 50-60 questions which UPSC is consistently asking. For example, this year they asked again about Ashoka's Rock Edict.
Right.
They asked about Web3. They asked about software as a service. UPSC has been consistent in these questions. So people should ensure that they have good understanding of those 50-60 questions. And how they can do that? They have to analyze the previous year questions.
Yes.
Because for example, I am an examiner. I have some guidelines. I can't make a question randomly. So please understand UPSC's prelims perspective. Those questions that are unpredictable, that will be unpredictable for all. Don't waste your time on those questions. Focus on those questions which will be there in the exam.
Which will be there in the exam. No, I think this is true for mains also. Because,
definitely.
We have closely analyzed mains papers. Weightage of marks from subject area. Now in paper 2, federalism, panchayat, elections, these are all repetitive themes.
Exactly.
Left-wing extremism, border management. So at least I think 20-30% is highly predictable. I would say
50-60%.
50. In I think mains, that will be too much of a claim. Right?
No, in mains it would increase because English. What will happen? They have mentioned left-wing extremism.
Right.
They are definitely going to ask one question.
That. cyber security, one question.
Definitely they will ask. I think UPSC syllabus is, should be the Bible. Their PYQ right. should be the Bible for that.
And even for a topic like IR, there is maximum what 20 issues. Myanmar, Afghanistan, you can count in your hands. If you prepare those issues, the question has to come from that. Did you experience something like that? Questions came from what you prepared in mains?
Actually, I think Arpit is more appropriate person to answer that question because I have not analyzed PYQs.
Okay. Now, from whatever you prepared, whatever test that you have written, did questions come from that?
अभी देखिए मुझे ऐसा याद नहीं कि किसमें क्वेश्चन रिपीट हुआ कि नहीं क्योंकि मैं तो सब्जेक्ट वाइज करता था थीम वाइज या फिर पी वाई क्यूज के हिसाब से मैंने प्रिपरेशन नहीं किया
सो यू वर टेकिंग पेपर टू एंड देन गोइंग सब्जेक्ट वाइज
हाँ कि पॉलिटी पढ़ लिया ज्योग्राफी पढ़ लिया हिस्ट्री पढ़ लिया मैं तो इसी तरह से कवर किया
नो एनालिसिस विद प्रीवियस ईयर्स पेपर
मुझे लगता है वो मैं मिस्टेक किया हूँ वो मुझे करना चाहिए था
आई थिंक यक्ष हैज अ नेचुरल एबिलिटी टू राइट वेरी गुड आंसर्स ही इज अ प्रोलिफिक रीडर He reads his newspaper,
right?
So he has a wider understanding,
wider understanding and more knowledge base.
Yes, right. My entire preparation was based on a process.
Okay,
so that is the difference between us. I think if he will write again, he will score definitely. But I had to go through the entire process again.
I think the GS score is something that is a validation.
Exactly,
464. Right. Yes. So I think it's among the top three scores of this year. I have not seen anybody above between you and rank one. So far, maybe there is somebody else, but as far as I understand, this is the second or third highest score. So, mains again, so last year we had only less days between prelims and mains. How did you strategize last year for mains?
Actually, I didn't have a strategy in detail. I was doing the whole time, last year bhi, is time bhi, maine sirf sociology padha tha. Aur GS ke liye maine jo mera prelims ke notes hote the, उनको रिवाइज कर लेता था क्योंकि उससे टाइमलाइन वगैरह फैक्ट्स मुझे याद फोर्डर पॉइंट्स मुझे मिल जाते थे और लास्ट ईयर मैंने करंट के लिए भी बहुत ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं किया था इस बार मैंने मेंस 365 पढ़ा था कुछ सब्जेक्ट का उसमें मैंने किया था
इट्स गेटिंग लिटिल बल्की मेंस 365 दैट्स वन ऑफ द थिंग्स आई
बट हेल्पफुल है उससे helpful तो डेटा मिल जाता है
एवरीथिंग कम्स फ्रॉम दैट बट द अमाउंट ऑफ रिविजंस दैट यू कैन डू आई थिंक दैट पार्ट इज
मैं तो एक ही बार पढ़ा था उसको अब मैं ये नहीं बोल सकता था उससे कितना आया कितना नहीं आया कितना यूजफुल
बट It helped you write better answers.
हाँ हाँ बिल्कुल But one thing is very important and that is data. मैंने data बहुत extensively उसको याद किया
था. I've seen one of your papers and I think you have extensively substantiated your content.
मैंने last year काफी bulky होता है polity का अलग आता है economy का अलग आता है This time मैंने only IS का भी data किया और उसको मैं जो important मुझे लगा दोनों का mix करके मैंने data बहुत ज़्यादा याद कर लिया था वो मुझे उधर भी मदद करता था
सो यू मेड अ सेपरेट नोट्स फ्रॉम ऑल दी सोर्सेस
उसी को मैंने हाईलाइट कर दिया था डेटा को
डिफरेंट कलर्स और समथिंग
सेम
कलर
हां उसको दो चार बार रिवाइज
आई हैड अ स्टूडेंट 2 3 इयर्स बैक ही यूज्ड टू नंबर्स फॉर वन कलर नेम्स फॉर वन कलर डिफरेंट पीपल वर्क डिफरेंटली राइट सो इन दैट सेंस फॉर यू एनी एक्सपीरियंस वेयर यू नो यू रिटन आंसर्स और यू प्रिपेयर्ड थिंग्स एंड डिड इट रिपीट इन मेंस
अगेन आई विल से प्रोसेस आई understood about PYQs as you said
right.
they will definitely ask one question about federalism they will right. definitely right. about local self government
right.
they will definitely about ask about
secularism was a very prominent
exactly.
urbanization
they will globalization they will
globalization
ask so I think we have to break them into sub
parts irrigation methodology
exactly
inclusive growth
they have mentioned everything
right
they will ask from that only for example again inclusive growth was there in paper
yeah. No, last 4 years there was a question on inclusive growth.
Exactly.
Like
so
year.
They will ask. I prepared my themes. I have subsections like paper one. I will go into polity. Then I'll subsection like federalism, local self. I had very crisp notes.
Notes
to an extent that I could revise them one day before the exam. For example, I came from one paper.
Right.
At 5, I will be home by 6. Within 3 hours, I can revise them paper. At least by seeing them from above, because. Eventually, what matters is writing in those 3 hours. And what happens is that when you segregate those topics, you are better able to understand UPSC. So when you are writing an answer of GS1, you can make a link to GS2 or GS3 or GS4 in that. So I think that helps.
No, and I think this crisp notes, now when people make notes, I tell that, you know, between one exam and the second exam, before you get in, you should be able to run through it. I think that crispness. Because one thing which I saw among many students is that, you know, बहुत अच्छा notes होता है, extensively made notes. But जो notes में है, it's not there in the answers.
Yes.
So then it is useless. So what is in the notes should be there in the answers.
That answer,
is the,
exactly.
That is the goal, right? So your optional is sociology, yours is maths. Max didn't work out as good as you yes. expected. Yes. Otherwise, you will be in the top 3 or top 10, very yes. likely. You are, right? How was Max this time? I am not qualified to ask that Max question, but I'll just ask a general question.
I think people scored good marks. I have a friend, Siddharth, who got 255 rank. He got 314 marks.
Right, right.
There is rank 54, I think. He also got 300, more than 300.
300.
So, people got good marks. I think I got less marks.
Relatively
yes.
lesser marks.
Yes. Right.
Sociology, how was it this year?
I think it was on the same expected lines. But I didn't analyze it analyze much the paper.
But you invested a lot of time on sociology this year.
Yes, I sociology a lot. Last year, I was a lot. Sociology, I didn't think there was any book that I didn't read. The standard books. I gave a lot of time sociology. You scored 285.
285.
285
in sociology. Right. Last mains, how much was your sociology score?
It was 252.
252. So 33 marks improvement.
No, that is not an improvement. Actually, I made a paper 2 mein thoda mistake kiya tha.
Okay.
Jo optional questions hote hain, wo sara part 2 se main karke aa gaya tha.
Okay. So there was a technical.
Technically same marks.
He would have made it to the list last year.
Last time, just because of this silly mistake. So mains of answer writing. Let's get into answer writing. Was there a different strategy for different papers, different topics? How was it?
एक्चुअली मेरा तो ऐसा अलग स्ट्रेटेजी नहीं था कुछ भी मैं तो बस लिखता था जो मेरे मन में आता था जो
इज देयर अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ अटेम्प्ट 1 टू 20 और पहले 15 मार्कर्स फिर 10 मार्कर्स
मैं तो 1 टू 20 शुरू से लिखना शुरू किया जो क्वेश्चन नहीं भी आता है उसको भी साथ में ही अटेम्प्ट किया बाद के लिए कुछ नहीं छोड़ा
राइट और एकदम सो इट वाज अ डायरेक्ट सीक्वेंस
यस और एकदम यूनिफॉर्मली सबको सारे क्वेश्चंस को टाइम दिया जो मुझे नहीं आता था उसमें भी मैंने इतना ही कंटेंट लिखा है जो मुझे बहुत अच्छे से आता था
आई वाज अबाउट टू आस्क द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन How did you deal with the S400 question or the LED question? How was your strategy for such questions?
Actually, LED वाला तो मुझे याद नहीं आ रहा है question आपका, but S400 का मुझे याद है। अभी S400 ये तो पता था हमको कि ये एक missile को attack करने वाला है। तो उसमें जो भी common सी चीजें हमको पता थी कि एक कुछ sensors होंगे जो उसको sense करेंगे, कुछ एक missile निकलेगा उसमें से, उसको attack करेगा ऐसा छोटा सा diagram बना दिया था उसको, और उसमें जो common से उन चीजें होती हैं सब वो सब लिख दिया था पॉइंट ये कि आप कुछ सही भी ना लिखे तो गलत भी ना लिखे आप एकदम जनरल जनरल चीजें
ब्रॉडली लिखे
ब्रॉड लिखे गलत नहीं हो कुछ भी तो कुछ तो मार्क्स मिलेंगे
आई रिमेंबर आस्किंग दिस क्वेश्चन टू अनदीप दुरेशेट्टी दैट ईयर द क्वेश्चन वाज डीकोलोनाइजेशन ऑफ मलाय पेनिनसुला सो ही सेड यू नो आई ड्रॉ अ मैप ऑफ मलाय पेनिनसुला एंड आई रोट अबाउट डीकोलोनाइजेशन मैंने और कुछ नहीं किया सो दिस साउंड्स समथिंग लाइक दैट यू नो यू राइट व्हाटएवर जनरल यू कैन थिंक ऑफ
एग्जैक्टली
एथिक्स एनी स्पेसिफिक डिफरेंट स्ट्रेटजी फॉर एथिक्स
हां उसके लिए मैंने डायग्राम्स अलग से किए थे
okay.
और मेरा स्ट्रेटेजी ऐसे स्ट्रेटेजी मैंने कभी सोचा नहीं कि ऐसा स्ट्रेटेजी तो बहुत बड़ा वर्ड है पर उसमें मैं थ्योरी यूज़ नहीं करता था उसमें सारा मैं प्रैक्टिकल चीज़ें उसमें लिखता था थ्योरी में वर्ड भी यूज़ नहीं करता था जैसे डिओंटोलॉजिकल टीलियोलॉजिकल ये सब मैं यूज़ नहीं करता था एकदम जो कॉमन सेंसिकल चीज़ें होती थी जो मेरी कॉमन समझ है उसके हिसाब से मैं लिखता था और उसमें मैंने डायग्राम्स बहुत ज़्यादा बनाए हैं लास्ट ईयर भी मैंने सारे क्वेश्चंस में डायग्राम बनाए थे
लास्ट ईयर एथिक्स का स्कोर कितना था
Last year 117 marks.
117. That is also a good score.
Yes. This year I got 126.
126.
सारे questions में मैंने diagrams बनाए. शुरू के 13 questions होते हैं. I drew diagrams.
So specific diagrams or broad Venn diagrams, pie charts, like how what kind, what type of diagrams?
जैसे case studies में flow charts बनाए. कहीं पे pie charts बनाया, कहीं पे दो चीजों का अगर mixture होता था, कहीं पे मैंने yes और no वाले diagrams बनाए कि अगर ऐसा होता है. कुछ होगा तो उससे ये होगा नहीं
like
होगा
a flow chart.
जो भी मैं ऊपर लिखा अपने आंसर में उसी को मैंने समराइज कर दिया अपने डायग्राम
so से इट्स अ रिपीटेशन ऑफ द कंटेंट द डायग्राम विल बी इजी टू इंटरप्रेट
डायग्राम इंटरप्रिटेशन में तो इजी रहता था बट उसको मैं कीवर्ड्स में डाल देता था जैसे ऊपर अगर मैंने कुछ लिखा है कि इंटीग्रिटी नहीं होगी कि इससे बहुत ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम्स होते हैं सोशल वेलफेयर नहीं होगा या कमिटमेंट नहीं होगा उसको मैं लिख देता था नीचे कि करप्शन होगा इससे नेपोटिज्म हो सकता है तो उसके जो कॉमन कॉमन वर्ड्स थे उसको मैं लिख देता था नीचे तो उससे पूरा आंसर मेरा समराइज हो जाता था
Visibility for keywords, but not using too much of technical keywords.
मैं बहुत ज़्यादा simple words use किया अपने सारे papers में ethics में भी मैं एकदम simple.
Did you collect a lot of examples?
मैं examples collect करने की कोशिश किया था, but उसको मैं कर नहीं पाया था. और जो भी examples मैंने लिखे वो मैंने current affairs से लिखे.
Whatever you read in newspapers, current context.
But मैंने examples ज़्यादा नहीं लिखे. Last year भी ज़्यादा नहीं लिखे थे.
So more emphasis on diagrams and keywords.
नहीं नहीं कीवर्ड्स में नहीं कीवर्ड्स तो मैं सिंपल लैंग्वेज में लिखता था एकदम बहुत सारे कीवर्ड्स नहीं भी होते थे, बट मैं एकदम कॉमन सेंसिकल लैंग्वेज में उसको लिखता था, जो बहुत ज़्यादा बेसिक बेसिक चीज़ें होती थी उसमें, उस पर मैं ज़्यादा ध्यान देता था, जो प्रैक्टिकल चीज़ें थी वो मैं लिखने पर ज़्यादा ध्यान देता था.
कंटिन्यूइंग विद दैट, कोर्ट बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस इन एथिक्स, एनी स्ट्रेटजी फॉर दैट, और हाउ डू यू डू दैट?
हाँ, उसके लिए मैं क्या करता था, देखिए मैं टेस्ट तो बहुत ज़्यादा लिखे नहीं है एथिक्स के भी, मैं अब तक मुझे लगता है कि शायद मैं एक टेस्ट लिखा हूँ एथिक्स का, वो भी लास्ट ईयर 2020 में. पर जब मैंने उसको देखा तो मैं ये सोच के गया था कि जो कोर्ट होगा उसको एक्सप्लेन कर देंगे इंट्रोडक्शन में, सिंपल लैंग्वेज में, शायद उसी को शायद रिफ्रेज करके लिख दें, उसको एक्सप्लेन कर देंगे. उसके बाद जो भी कोर्ट है उसको डिफरेंट डिफरेंट डायमेंशंस में एक्सप्लेन कर देंगे, जो भी जैसे नीड वर्सेस ग्रीड का अगर आ जाता है गांधी जी का कोर्ट, तो उसको इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस से रिलेट कर देंगे, एनवायरनमेंट से रिलेट कर देंगे, सिविल सर्विसेज से रिलेट कर देंगे, सोसाइटी से रिलेट कर देंगे, या जो भी कोई और डायमेंशन है उसमें उसको एक्सप्लेन कर देंगे बस. और एक्सप्लेन करके जो भी आ गया है उसको डायग्राम बना देंगे और एक सिंपल सा कंक्लूजन दे के आगे बढ़ जाएंगे.
I'll continue with ethics for you. You have also done reasonably well in ethics. Your score is
116.
How was your strategy for ethics?
I think this is a good strategy that you write basic things which are more practical. I focused on certain other aspects, like I had certain philosophies which are very basic, which everyone can understand, such as John Rawls' theory of justice,
right,
or Gandhi's talisman. So I made a note of around 20 to 25 such philosophies. I tried to mention them. I made a note of examples, certain examples that are current based or famous examples. For example, although I didn't use that in the recent Olympics, some players because of mental health they didn't participate,
right?
So that showed courage,
right,
in some sense. So those current examples, or international relations example, that how India generally focus more on peace. So these basic examples, so basically examples, then philosophies, and if possible basic definitions of the keywords.
Diagrams?
I tried to make diagrams. Actually, we prepared together as far as diagrams are concerned. So I also tried to incorporate diagrams. For example, an example of diagram can be if you are answering a case study and you have to take a stand, then you can use determinant of ethics. There are certain determinant of factors. Ethics factors, like what was the condition in which you are taking a decision, or what is the impact of that decision.
Right.
So I used to make a diagram. I first thought before itself that I'll make around 4 to 5 diagrams in case studies also.
Okay.
And in the part one, also I tried to make diagrams to show a chain, for example, that if you do this, then this can happen.
Sequence diagram.
Sequence time. So we diagrams we prepared together only, X and I.
So there's a separate diagram notes.
Basically, you have to have that in mind before itself.
Right.
I think you cannot just learn particular diagram, but you can learn that what type of diagram you can
in
draw
in this
there.
Context you use.
Yes, exactly.
Right.
So you cannot learn that I'll definitely make this particular diagram with these words, but you can learn that I will make this flow chart, this type of flow chart, if this type of question comes. Okay. So I think that will help.
I want to add one thing. We have used one book by Mudit Jain sir,
the red color
book. I have learned
decode ethics and decode ethics.
We both have learned the diagrams from that book.
I suggest helpful. That book, decode ethics and ethics. Two books are there of Mudit.
But in decode ethics, I think more focus should be on you read the PYQs, PYQ question, then you see how the diagrams he has made. He will elaborate more on this.
So उसमें थ्योरी तो इतना अच्छा मुझे नहीं लगा किताब का, बट जो डायग्राम्स थे उनका अच्छा था.
इट्स अ कलेक्शन ऑफ प्रीवियस ईयर सॉल्व्ड पेपर्स, लास्ट 5 ईयर सॉल्व्ड पेपर्स.
यस यस, पीवाईक्यू उसके सॉल्यूशंस थे.
right.
तो उसी में से उसमें से जब उसको पढ़ा हमने, तो बहुत सारे कीवर्ड्स भी, जैसे जो स्पेशली डायग्राम में जो कीवर्ड्स यूज होते हैं कि नेपोटिज्म होगा, करप्शन होगा, सोशल वेलफेयर नहीं होगा, कमिटमेंट नहीं होगा, डेडिकेशन नहीं होगा, वो सब वहीं से सीख लिया था, जो कीवर्ड सॉरी जो डायग्राम बनाने का.
I have been recommending this book for last 3-4 years. I think it's he launched it in 18 or 19 if I remember.
But there is one catch in this, it is a bulky book.
Bulky book.
So again what he's saying, ethics is more about writing than right. about content. Basically notes, it is about notes, but you
don't make it too complex.
Don't make it too complex. Don't read bulky books. Make it more personalized.
Okay.
And write good answers. Then
more relatable.
More relatable. More, you have to convince someone. You have to tell them what you are thinking.
I have a theory on this. I feel every other subject could be checked by subject experts. geography mein masters hai, but for ethics I don't think there are subject experts. So the complex keywords that we use might not be relatable to the person who's checking.
Exactly.
And when you're writing simple stuff, it may be more relatable. To him. And this is something that we are seeing in the last few years. People who write simple stuff with current contemporary examples, you know. I think the feeling it gives to the evaluator is that, you know, he knows what he's writing. He's yes. able to relate to exactly. things around him.
Exactly.
That's probably why it is working. Moving on in ethics itself, case studies. Do you write introductions for case studies?
Yes. Introduction maine sare case studies mein likha. Uske baad ek chota sa diagram bana dete the, stakeholders ka bana dete the.
What type of introduction?
Introduction jo case hota tha usi ko thoda sa explain kar dete the, do teen line mein ki this
summarize.
Case, yes, ki this case involves this 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 ya this ethical dilemma involved tha. Uske baad ek chota sa diagram ki ye stakeholders the ya fir ek issues bana dete, ethical diagram, ethical dilemmas ka ek diagram bana diya. इस तरह से करके फिर जो क्वेश्चन पूछा जाता था उसको हैंडल करते थे.
कंक्लूजन्स इन केस स्टडीज?
हाँ, कंक्लूजन भी मैं देता था. मैंने इनफैक्ट मुझे जैन सर की किताब से ही वो सीखा कि अगर हम ये स्टेप्स लेते हैं तो इससे सारे स्टेक होल्डर्स का जो वो कंसर्न्स है वो कवर हो जाते हैं. इस तरह के कंक्लूजन्स मैंने उसमें लिखे थे. बेसिकली कंक्लूजन्स में मैं समराइज ही कर देता था जो मैं ऊपर लिखता था. बिल्कुल.
आई थिंक देयर वाज अ स्ट्रेटजी दैट वाज गोइंग अराउंड लास्ट ईयर दैट यू नो कंक्लूजन शुड बी attributing your decision to something which is higher than you. Your decision was based on Gandhian talisman. So, sir, this is not my idea alone. This is also the same values that Gandhi would have taken or Ambedkar would have taken or something like that. Some kind of summarization.
Sir, मैं ये सब theories मैं use नहीं करता था.
Right.
अपने उसमें. शायद हो सकता है करें तो अच्छा रहे, पर मैं नहीं करता था.
This is a good way, I think, right. because they have mentioned like philosophies, philosophers. So, if you can tell them that I am guided ethically by this value or I am guided ethically by constitution.
We had a student who had mugged up the motto of all the services.
Okay.
Satyame Vijayate.
Yeah, yeah.
So he used to write that, you know, last May ki, this decisions were guided by the values of Satyame Vijayate. Okay. Right. So it was basically saying that, you know, this is not my decision alone. If somebody of a higher ethical value was in my position, they would do the same thing.
I think it will make it more than your own self.
There was somebody else who used to do that. You know, there were a lot of current context case studies that used to come. So they will, in the end, also talk about, you know, what the actual person in that situation did. So I think what something like that would do is that, you know, you are telling the evaluator, I know why you have asked this question. This is a good question. So some kind of a praise.
I sometimes do that in introduction.
Introduction.
I write.
Context.
We can write the context of current affairs in that recently right. it happened. But I think you can diversify your introductions.
You diversified or everything was same? Different types of introductions for different case studies.
Case studies में तो मैं जो लिखा हुआ होता था case study में उसी को
standard
explain कर देता था थोड़ा सा बस.
Summarization plus stakeholders.
हाँ, stakeholders के बारे में.
Right. Ethics paper.
पर मुझे लगता है कि अर्पित का strategy इसमें ही नहीं, पूरे GS में, पूरा mains में बहुत structured उसका strategy है. मेरा तो एकदम हैफ़ज़ार्ड था, मेरा कोई ऐसा grand strategy नहीं था. Ethics में भी मैं बस
the difference between you both is 17 marks in GS and that is half mark here, half mark there. I don't think it will be big difference.
During preparation I used to tell him I am more of a process guy
right.
and you are natural,
natural
then you will write
right.
naturally. So I think we help
both
each
works.
Other in that way.
Both works right. So moving on from there, I think one paper that has not been doing well in the last 3-4 years is GS3. If you see this year's score also, last year's score also, how can somebody work on GS3? How to improve GS3 scores? You have how much marks in GS3? You have
100 or
99 for you and you have scored 102. I think this year's the highest mark is 108 in GS3.
Okay.
How is your strategy in paper 3?
मैंने तो ऐसा कोई स्पेसिफिक तैयारी नहीं किया GS3 के लिए.
डाटा
सब सेम था. डेटा मैंने तो डेटा सब सारे सब्जेक्ट्स के लिए याद किया था. वो स्पेसिफिक GS3 नहीं था. लास्ट ईयर भी मेरा GS3 में नंबर कम था. अर्पित का बहुत अच्छा था, शायद अर्पित और अच्छे से उसको बता पाए.
मैप्स इन पेपर 3, एनवायरमेंट सिक्योरिटी मैप्स डालते थे?
मैप्स मैं IR के बनाता था, जैसे इंडो पैसिफिक का. इस बार मेरा फोकस था डायग्राम्स में, GS1-3 में भी.
ओके.
कि इंडो पैसिफिक का बना दिया कोई वर्ल्ड मैप.
सो पेपर 3 में अगर लेफ्ट विंग एक्सट्रीमिज्म क्वेश्चन इज देयर, विल यू वुड इंक्लूड अ मैप?
हां, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल.
Okay. How is your strategy for paper 3?
I think we have to, paper 3 is the most bulky paper. So what you end up getting lost in the final paper.
Right.
But you can break it into subsections.
Completely for example, agree on that.
You will get six questions on security.
I have the breakup. Economy 50 marks, two 10 markers, two 15 markers. Question number 1, 2, question number 11, 12. This is the usual pattern.
And that too, you can tell, like, one is inclusive growth.
And two conceptual questions.
Conceptual questions
are repeating now.
Repeat, and you will easily do them with the prelims knowledge.
Prelims knowledge.
And then inclusive growth prepare different separately, and one more question you can prepare separately.
Then four agriculture.
You can prepare them also.
Irrigation.
Irrigation.
Then you have cropping pattern.
Cropping pattern.
PDS, MSP, livestock missions.
Exactly.
Yehi aata hai. Then you have security, four questions, 50 marks.
Yes.
Two 10 markers, two 15 markers. We set the question paper. Yes. So we put this combination. Science and tech, 50 marks, four questions. Science and tech also, I think a lot of themes repeat. AI, blockchain, machine learning, these things also keep.
Nanotechnology,
these things. Environment and disaster management put together, another 50 marks.
Yes.
This is the combination. So you break it down into smaller parts.
Smaller part. Right. For example, if I am attempting a left-wing extremism question, so I will have a particular data that I will definitely use in that. For example, Ministry of Home Affairs will release a data.
Area under left-wing extremism.
Last 5 years, how many people got killed? How many people, extremists surrendered?
Right.
So I had that data.
In the introduction?
In the body part. Very crisp.
Very crisp.
I know that they will definitely ask about it. This. Or border management, you can make a diagram. Or for instance, in terrorism, how many people got killed?
So in that sense, we can pre-prepare all these
exactly.
data.
I have like around 3 to 4 page notes for left-wing extremism. They will definitely ask the next day, I'll revise
one
it.
One question is very high chance.
Definitely. Right. They will ask definitely for sure. Last year, I think they asked, two questions.
Left-wing extremism.
Yeah. They ask something from security, they ask two questions. For example, border management, they will definitely ask. So I think, I personally feel paper 3 is the most bulky one, but it is the most tameable paper.
And most difficult to score also.
Difficult because what is happening is that people generally throughout the preparation read about GS3 a lot.
And I think a disproportionate emphasis is given on economy and not on agriculture.
Exactly.
So some areas are blind spot for.
And they don't ask economy much. They will ask about inclusive growth every year.
every year.
So if you have those keywords, then you can answer those questions.
Science and tech also similar nature.
Science and tech, you need to understand what is science and tech. Mm-hmm. There is not just ICT. Mm-hmm. There is also nanotechnology. There is also space technology, biotechnology. So if you can somehow relate to all these subsectors in one answer itself, then I think that will also help you.
Paper 2, I think you have a better understanding. You have scored one of the highest scores also in paper 2, right? Paper 2, you had 126. I think that's one of the highest scores. Highest is 128. 127 or 128. How was paper 2 strategy? Same standard current affairs.
GS में मैं न्यूज़पेपर बहुत अच्छे से पढ़ता था
right.
वैसा सब्जेक्ट वाइज या पेपर वाइज मैंने स्ट्रेटजी नहीं बनाया था
right.
जो भी मैं पढ़ा मैंने समझ के पढ़ा उसको न्यूज़पेपर ने जैसे आपने अभी GS3 के बारे में डिस्कस किया ना जैसे PDS एग्रीकल्चर या सिक्योरिटी ये न्यूज़पेपर में बहुत अच्छे से कवर होते थे okay. मैंने ऐसा इसको स्पेसिफिक अलग से नहीं पढ़ा इनको
आई थिंक योर मेमोरी इज योर बिगेस्ट एडवांटेज वंस यू रीड यू आर एबल टू रिकॉलेक्ट
वो जो अंडरस्टैंडिंग क्रिएट होती है न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ के एक तो सारा कुछ कवर तो हो ही जाता है
एंड देन डाटा यू एक्सट्रैक्ट एंड यू रिवाइज द डाटा
रिलेट कर पाते हैं जैसे कोई भी क्वेश्चन आता है ना ऑटोमेटिकली आता था दिमाग में कि हमको ये चीजें इसमें लिखनी है ऐसे ही GS2 में भी था GS1 में तो शायद स्टैटिक ज्यादा है ऐसा मैंने स्ट्रेटेजी अलग अलग तो नहीं बनाया था जो
यू हैड अ कॉमन स्ट्रेटेजी
मैं तो बोलता हूँ कि मैं तो सब में एक जैसा लिख के आया था GS2 में नंबर ज्यादा है पता नहीं क्यों ज्यादा है
राइट समटाइम्स यू रियलाइज आई हैड अ रैंक होल्डर इन 2017 और 18 एसए में सबसे हाईएस्ट मार्क्स आया था
अच्छा
एंड यू आस्क दैट पर्सन इज लाइक यू नो शी इज नॉट श्योर व्हाई शी गॉट द हाईएस्ट मार्क्स इन एसए सो समथिंग लाइक दैट यू हैव डन द सेम स्ट्रेटजी फॉर 1 2 3 4
देखिए मैं प्रीलिम्स और मेंस के बीच में मैं अपना सोशियोलॉजी पढ़ता था मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स मैं बोलता हूं 90-95% ऑफ द टाइम्स बट मैं न्यूज़पेपर में बहुत अच्छे से पढ़ा था न्यूज़पेपर से जो अंडरस्टैंडिंग मेरी बनी मुझे लगता है कि 50% से ज्यादा मार्क्स तो मेरे जीएस में सिर्फ न्यूज़पेपर
के अंडरस्टैंडिंग
वो मैं बहुत अच्छे से करता था उसका डेली करंट अफेयर्स करता था जैसे फॉलो करता था उसको उससे मेरी अंडरस्टैंडिंग बहुत अच्छी बनी जीएस की कोई सा भी सब्जेक्ट हो जैसे सिक्योरिटी बताया मैंने नहीं पढ़ा था बहुत ज़्यादा सिक्योरिटी अलग से बट मैंने न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ा था मुझे कोई भी क्वेश्चन दिया जाता था मैं उसको सॉल्व कर सकता था
right. So it was directly related to the current affairs that you were consuming.
Huh.
And static, you have already made your notes and you are revising from that. Huh. So it's a collection
current of work. Current newspaper se static bhi revise hoi jata hai. Jaise Naxalism hota hai. To thoda interest ke saath usko
context wo de dete hai.
Context de dete hai. Thoda hum Google kar lete hai usko. Se Naxalism ke upar aata hai. To Naxalism ki definition to dekhi lete hai. Wikipedia pad lete hai thoda. To se static bhi cover ho jata hai. Current to hoi jata hai cover.
Aur end mein 10 din pehle data.
Data.
Data. Right. Data. Right. Yes. I think one trend that we are seeing in paper 2, paper 3 is that people are giving a lot of data. Like in one answer, there are 5-6 constitutional articles, one or two judgments. So the intensity of data points is increasing.
Huh.
That is, I think, what one of the new trends that we are seeing. And diagrams are reasonably back in business because yes. After 2017, diagrams had gone down because everybody was drawing diagrams in everything.
Actually, there the relevance of the diagrams matters.
Is important, right?
We should add only those diagrams which add value to the answers.
Right.
It should not be irrelevant. Otherwise, it would irritate the examiner.
Role of answer writing in mains preparation. You wrote one paper with us. Mm-hmm. You have written six papers with us. How important is answer writing for mains preparation?
वैसे मैंने तो ज़्यादा नहीं किया
यू हैव नॉट रिटन मच
बट जैसे अर्पित से मैं बात करता रहता था बाकी दोस्तों से भी बात करता रहता था मुझे लगता है कि बहुत ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है वो सीखना डायग्राम्स भी बिना प्रैक्टिस के नहीं बना सकते हम इंट्रोडक्शन कंक्लूजन हो इनफैक्ट हम डेटा भी नहीं ऐड कर सकते हैं जब तक हम उसको प्रैक्टिस ना करके जाए कि डेटा को एग्जैक्टली लिखना कैसे ब्रैकेट में
कहाँ पे यूज़ करना है
तो ये सब चीज़ें बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी मैंने तो बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं किया जैसे इस बार मैंने एक आपके साथ लिखा एक टेस्ट या दो टेस्ट में विजन के लिखा मैं जीएस का दो तीन टेस्ट मैंने सोशियोलॉजी का लिखा बस मैंने इतना ही आंसर राइटिंग किया था पर ये बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है
बट इफ यू वर टू डू इट डिफरेंटली यू वुड हैव रिटन मोर
अगर मुझे टाइम दिया जाए कि आप दोबारा से मींस दे तो
इस साल पिछले साल से 1 महीना ज्यादा है टाइम
1 महीना
ऑलमोस्ट लाइक यू नो लास्ट टाइम इट वाज 83 दिस टाइम इट्स 103 और 105 डेज सो इट्स ऑलमोस्ट 20-25 डेज मोर कंपेयर टू लास्ट
दैट इज अ लॉट
राइट यू हैव रिटन extensively
yes
compared to your last attempt versus this year how was it
I think it was almost similar I used to write around two papers each for four papers so it is around eight
did you do any stimulators as in 2 days back to back 1 2 3 4
last year I did I wrote four papers for two consecutive days this year I wrote two papers on a single day
We had a rank holder last year who said she had done 3 times stimulator, basically to experience that fatigue of writing 4 papers consecutively.
More importantly, to experience whether you can revise something or not, because you are in a misconception that you will get some time, but it is very less time and you are highly tired. So you should have understanding of that.
Even writing the ethics paper on the second day, the last 1 hour, you get very tired. By then. Essay, I think you both have done almost similar score.
We have similar marks, 130.
Last year, how was your essay score?
It was around 126, I think.
So this is a significant improvement this year.
Yeah,
it's not a 4-mark improvement because it's a big upgrade. For you, what was the score last year?
It was 133.
133. So you have more or less. But I think 130 this year is better than 133 last year.
Abhi is baar philosophical essays the, toh it might be considered that way.
How do you approach philosophical topics? Especially the topics like, you know, this year's topics are very weird this year. How do you approach essay topics?
Actually, वैसे बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छा score तो नहीं है मुझे तो लगता है 130 भी.
I think on a relative basis, from what I have seen, there is only 10 or 15 people who have scored above 140 maximum.
तो उसके लिए मैं क्या करता था? कि जो ऐसे का टॉपिक होता था उसको डिवाइड कर देता एक एक वर्ड में जैसे कि मैंने इस बार ऐसे लिखा था बेटर प्रैक्टिसेस वाला जो था देयर इज ऑलवेज अ बेटर प्रैक्टिसेस टू द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस
राइट
तो उसमें तोड़ लेता था ऐसे को कि एक एक डायमेंशन हो गया बेस्ट प्रैक्टिस हो गया एक बेटर प्रैक्टिसेस हो गया अब हमको पता चल गया कि इसको इम्प्रूव करना है अब हमको सर्च करना है कि बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस कौन सी थी हिस्टोरिकल बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस कौन सी थी अभी कौन सी बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस हैं और उनसे बेटर पहले उनसे बेटर क्या हुआ है और जो अभी चल रही है उनसे बेटर कुछ हो सकता है क्या उसी को फिर जो भी उसमें लिखा फिर उसमें डायमेंशंस थोड़ा कि सोशल में क्या इकोनॉमिकल पॉलिटिकल और जो भी था उनको रिलेट करके जो ऊपर पूछा गया उसी से रिलेट करके बस उस पर
इंट्रोडक्शंस इन एसेज कैसे लिखते थे मतलब हाउ डू यू इंट्रोड्यूस
देखिए मैं तो कुछ तैयार नहीं किया था ना इंट्रोडक्शन ना कंक्लूजन मैं तो जो नेचुरली आता था जो भी दिमाग में उस टाइम पे आता था
स्टोरी टाइप होता है कोई कोट डाल के इंट्रोड्यूस करता है
हाँ लास्ट ईयर मुझे याद है कि एक ऐसे था हिडन पैट्रियार्की के ऊपर उसमें मैंने एक एनिकडोट भी नहीं बोलेंगे कि स्टोरी बनाया था मैंने कि जहाँ पे मैंने बच्चे को, एक गर्ल चाइल्ड को और एक बॉय चाइल्ड को कंपेयर किया था कि वो जब घर में रहते थे उसका सोशलाइजेशन उस तरह से होता है, उस तरह से होता है, वो सोशियोलॉजी से मैंने रिलेट किया था। इस बार जो बेटर प्रैक्टिसेस वाला था उसमें मैंने मार्क्स की थ्योरी लिखी थी कि पहले कम्युनिज्म को हम बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस बोलते थे बट अभी कैपिटलिज्म ज़्यादा बेटर माना जाता है। तो इस तरह तो जो नेचुरली आता था मैं वो
लिखता था। यूज डायग्राम्स इन एसे आल्सो?
नो नो,
देयर आर सम स्टूडेंट्स हु यूज डायग्राम्स इन एसे आल्सो।
मैंने तो कोई डायग्राम यूज नहीं,
हेडिंग्स, सब हेडिंग्स ऐसे यूज किया था,
दो तीन हेडिंग्स में डाल देता था उसमें,
बेसिकली टू डिवाइड द एसे इनटू डिफरेंट पार्ट्स।
एक तो उससे समझ आ जाता ना यहाँ पे मैंने ये चीज कवर किया है।
डाटा इन एसे एग्जाम्पल्स,
डेटा मैं लिख देता था, जैसे हिडन पैट्रियार्की के ऊपर मैं डेटा लिखा था, जो मैं जीएस वाला डेटा था वो काफी लिखा था उसमें।
सो यू वुड हैव ब्रॉट थिंग्स फ्रॉम सोशियोलॉजी आल्सो?
हां, सोशियोलॉजी का तो मैं काफी यूज करता था।
सोशियोलॉजी रियली हेल्प्स इन एसे?
हां, मुझे तो लगता है बहुत हेल्प किया मुझे तो।
राइट, फॉर यू एसे हाउ वाज इट?
सिमिलरली देयर वर मोर फिलोसफिकल टॉपिक्स दिस ईयर। आई थिंक वी हैव टू स्टार्ट बाय अंडरस्टैंडिंग द टॉपिक।
देयर इज ओनली फिलोसफिकल टॉपिक दिस ईयर? यस, आई थिंक इट इज स्लोली मूविंग टुवर्ड्स ऑल फिलोसफिकल टॉपिक्स।
So my prime thing that a person should do, stick to the topic. And if you are unable to understand the topic, please don't write about it.
No, what I tell people is, after every page, go back and read the topic one time, because you don't know where you're headed.
Because there you will lose around 15 to 20 marks. So that is the starting
and
point.
And this time essay score is also, many people have got 60, 70, 80. Yes. Misinterpretation has been a serious issue in philosophical
topics. Actually, I'll tell you an anecdote. Hmm. We both went to paper in the same way. When we came back to the auto, तो एक ऐसे था कि द हैंड्स विच रॉक द क्रेडल रूल्स द वर्ल्ड। अर्पित से मैंने बोला यार तूने किया क्या? बोला कि मैंने तो नहीं किया। मैंने पूछा अगर तू करता तो क्या लिखता? तो इसने जो इंटरप्रिटेशन दिया उसका और जो मैंने इंटरप्रिटेशन दिया वो एकदम अलग था,
कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट। आई थिंक दैट वाज अ चैलेंज दिस ईयर।
तो आई लेफ्ट दैट पार्ट बिकॉज़ प्राइमरीली ऑफ दिस,
बिकॉज़ आई थिंक देयर आर डिफरेंट डिबेट्स, फेमिनिज्म पे है, पेरेंटिंग पे है, लाइक यू नो दैट्स कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन। एंड देयर वाज वन एसे व्हिच वाज वेरी डिफिकल्ट, योर परसेप्शन ऑफ मी इज the topic was also very
so
different.
Interpretation is very important.
Interpret, you have to interpret it properly
and stick to the demand of the topic.
They have mentioned the syllabus of essay, like clear and logical exposition. Then you have to make it continuous. There should be no flow should be continuous. Also try to incorporate all the GS papers, non-GS papers also. For example, I also wrote there are better practices than the best practices. So I started with like some earlier there was feudalism, then people found a better practice is monarchy, then they found constitutionalism, democracy. Still there was with constitutionalism there was still no rights to women,
right?
Then they found democracy, then right. They John Rawls came with his theory of justice, then later on Amartya Sen said that there should be capability enhancement, right. But there is still a better practice where all people are equal
and there could be still better practices which
exactly
you don't know.
And then I divided into sub parts, for example in social life what are the better practices, or in political space what can be even better. For example, currently India has democracy, but democracy in completely decentralized form, it should be our aim. So in that way across sectors also,
so thinking broadly and ensuring flow and good interpretation.
Exactly, if you are moving from one paragraph to another there should be flow, that way you can ensure about more than 115 and 120. I think with the attempting to get more than 140 and landing up with less than 110
no, 140, should not 150 be done. And all is random and it's
yes
we don't know because sometimes it works, sometimes yes. It don't work, like you said paper 2 or paper 3 sab mein maine same kiya tha, paper 2 mein zyada aa gaya, like that kind of a situation. You said you mentioned took a lot of time on sociology between prelims and mains, and maths is also very time consuming.
Yes,
so how much time would you have given for maths vis-a-vis GS?
I think it would be around in the first two months of, there are 3 months, in the first 2 months I gave around 70% time to maths, 30% to GS. In the last month I gave around 40% time to maths and 60% to GS. I think people should study more GS in the last month because it is extensive and you end up remembering those things more because optional is more academic in nature. So
more conceptual
so
this is more factual.
Yes, right? Yes.
So if you were writing this year, let's say you don't have to write this year, how would you strategize in the next 3 months?
My math score is very less, it's around 257. So I'll write a lot of test papers.
Right.
I think I did a mistake there. I wrote very less tests in maths because there is not a very big peer group in maths paper. So I will write more maths paper, definitely.
And what would you do if you were writing this year?
One, I'll prepare GS very well. Secondly, I would like to write more papers.
More papers.
Yes.
More paper. What would you have done differently last year if you were to do something different? More time on GS Center?
More number of papers and more time on the GS. That would be my two priorities.
Right. For you?
For me, I would, for example, I was thinking like if I have to write again, if I don't get into
IS. That fear is always there. Yes, I have to prepare again.
So I would have extensively written test papers in maths for people who are watching. They have to write more maths paper because eventually it is about practice. And in maths, it is more about temperament in the paper and choosing the right portion. Because for example, in sociology, if you end up choosing a wrong subsection, mm-hmm. you might lose 5 to 10 marks. But in maths, you can lose 30 to 40 marks. I did that mistake this year.
It's right or wrong?
Yes. So it is a binary, 0 or 1. So I think I would write more tests and develop a temperament.
I had a top 10 rank holder in 2018. Who wrote 50 papers between GS? I'm not talking about optional. 50 papers between prelims and mains.
Okay.
Every day one paper.
Oh.
So he was like, you know, eventually, raat ko ek baje bhi, if you wake him up, no, he'll write. Anything you give, he'll write.
Okay.
So I think writing always helps.
Yes.
Finally, to the interview preparation. I think this is your both of you. This is the second interview.
Yes.
How was your this year's interview preparation different from last year?
This year, I think I prepared less this year. I don't know
how many mocks did you give?
Mocks I gave around six to seven mocks.
Right.
Mocks are always helpful, but make sure you learn about the process.
Right.
And I still believe, although I have 168 marks, but I believe that confidence and presence of mind. Sometimes, and you can tell them that sorry, I was wrong. I am changing my opinion this year. For example, I'll tell you this year's interview. They asked me about pressure group. So they asked me, are they good? I said, yes, they are good, but they can be bad also. So while coming out, sir asked me, the chairperson asked me, do you want to tell us something? So I was thinking I should have told them that.
Right.
Sir, I would like to correct myself that I said that pressure groups are good, but they might be bad also.
Right.
So I think that presence of mind and balance.
Which board was this?
RN Chaubey, sir.
RN Chaubey, sir.
Yes.
How was your interview preparation this year?
Actually, last year I got 146.
146, okay.
And this year I got 154.
Okay.
And
but I think this year's 154 is much better.
Much better.
Much better because last year the interview scores went up to 215.
215.
This time it's 205, I think.
Yes. Yeah.
So I did few different things as compared to last year. One, I gave more number of mocks.
How because many?
14 to 15 mocks.
14 to 15 mocks,
yes.
Okay.
Because in my last interview, I was underconfident and I was a little nervous in the interview. So I had to improve my communication skills. I have to improve my confidence speaking to the senior members.
Your medium was English itself or English?
My medium
only?
Was English.
English only.
Yes.
Right.
Yes. So more number of mocks, more speaking or communication practice. So these were my two.
Did you get any questions which were repeated like, you know, from mock interviews to UPSC?
Yes, yes. There were many questions.
Many questions. In that way, I think it helps.
Almost. I would say more than 60-70% of the questions were from my DAF itself.
DAF itself.
And I practiced them in the interview.
And you had got that in some interview or the other.
Yes, but although I failed to communicate well to the board and I got 154 marks.
When we used to sit together, when we talk to each other, we end up giving very good views on subjects.
Right.
But as soon as we sit in front of the board.
Panel, right.
So in front of the panel, I think our performance reduces a lot.
And I think confidence is a big factor.
Confidence is a big factor. And I think sometimes it happens that you sometimes fall short of vocabulary. That problem
expressing
I face.
Expressing what is in your head.
Exactly.
Right.
That vocabulary problem I face a lot.
And that will lead to miscommunication.
Miscommunication.
Because you are saying something and they don't understand that factor.
Last
question. Anything that you want to pass on to the aspirants with respect to the whole process of preparation?
पहले तो मैं ये बोलना चाहूँगा कि थोड़ा confidence होना चाहिए, थोड़ा motivation होना चाहिए, internal motivation, क्योंकि वो आपकी consistency और perseverance जो है, उसको maintain रखेगा. थोड़ा सा confidence और चीजों को पढ़ने का जो तरीका होना चाहिए, वो सही होना चाहिए. चीजों को समझ के इधर उधर relate करके चीज़ों को जो याद करने वाली याद करना, कंसेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी के साथ पढ़ना, क्योंकि वही चीज़ प्रीलिम्स, मेंस या इंटरव्यू तीनों स्टेजेस पर वही चीज़ काम आने वाली है. दूसरा, प्रैक्टिस करें. मैं कम प्रैक्टिस किया, मैं पछताता हूँ अभी, मुझे रिग्रेट है उस चीज़ का कि मुझे प्रीलिम्स में भी टेस्ट देने चाहिए थे, PYQs करने चाहिए थे, मुझे मोर नंबर ऑफ टेस्ट लिखने चाहिए थे मेंस में. तो प्रैक्टिस बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है. बैकग्राउंड में जो बैकएंड है वो आपकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग हो, कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी, सारे टॉपिक्स को कवर करना चाहिए. और जो फाइनली जो हमको प्रैक्टिस करना है, PYQs हो या फिर प्रीलिम्स के टेस्ट हो या जो मेंस के टेस्ट हो, वो करना चाहिए.
एंड फॉर योर
फर्स्ट इज दैट देयर विल बी फेलियर्स. यू हैव टू स्टैंड अप बिकॉज यू विल बी अलोन इन दोज फेलियर्स. सो डोंट लूज योर कॉन्फिडेंस. सेकेंडली एनीवन कैन क्लियर UPSC. थर्डली यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन PYQs and syllabus in each and every aspect.
That should be very clear.
Extremely clear. And you have to understand your strengths. For example, Yaksh has a different strength. I have a different strength. I knew that I have to follow the process. So I think you have to understand that.
Who are you and what works for you?
Exactly. Thirdly, practice. I think you have to develop that thing in yourself. Like if you are given any answer, you will write that. That will come with practice only. And one thing that I faced problem throughout the process was aiming for perfection.
That is a big problem.
There is nothing like perfection. I think even if we will retire in the after the service, one person was asking me yesterday itself, so do you think mere andar knowledge hai? Mujhe lagta hai mere andar itni knowledge nahi hai. Maine kaha a person who is retiring after the service, he won't also have that much knowledge. So I think don't aim for perfection. You can aim for excellence. This might sound cliche.
Right.
But this is not cliche.
It's a very good advice.
Don't aim for perfection. Just keep on hustling. Keep on practicing.
Hustling. Right, yes. That's the word. Right.
Yes.
No, because I keep telling people that even if you get one more year, it's not going to make a big difference.
No difference.
People compare a UPSC exam with graduation and plus two exam.
No, it is not.
You will never have complete command over the subject. You'll never be satisfied with your preparation. I've never heard anybody say that, I'm ready, give me the paper. Yes.
For example, there is one thing like there was our senior Vikram Grewal, sir.
Right.
He wrote brilliant essays. Okay. If I start comparing myself with him, as far as essays are concerned, and his rank was around 40, my rank is 53.
Right.
Had I gone mad, right, I have to write the perfect essay, I wouldn't land up anywhere.
Somebody had very nicely said that, there are now this year there are 685 different strategies to clear the exam.
Yes, exactly.
Everybody has a different strategy. Yes. I think different things work for different people.
You can understand that what is working for you is by practice, even smaller things like retention capacity.
Right.
I might have a different process to remember things.
Even in this whole conversation, your approach has been completely different from mine. Your approach.
Yes. Right. So, what I did is I tried to learn something from his, but I didn't try to replicate.
Never doubt your ability to clear his exam.
Yes.
Right. And I think people from different backgrounds, first attempters, ninth attempters, different success stories are coming out.
And don't think that I should qualify in the first attempt itself. And also don't believe people who say that there's no need to study much in UPSC.
Right.
Because those are exceptions. If you are exception, that is well enough for you.
I think there was a response by the government for that additional attempt. Prelims is only required to study 15 days. So that is... I think another problem is that, people somewhere believe that, this is the only thing I can do in my life.
Yes.
Right. So much pressure towards the outcome is there among a lot of people.
Let me tell you, we got into service. Now we start feeling that it's not just about IAS. I have already started thinking about the future.
Future.
That it is worthless if I don't do good work.
Good work.
And that good work can
legacy
be done.
Legacy is a factor now. Legacy of what legacy, you do.
Exactly. And that can be done everywhere. For example, if a person is doing a startup, he is contributing immensely to the society. Even there might be a situation that an IAS can't contribute that much.
Right.
So I think it's about...
No, treat this as an exam and
It is an exam, sir. Nobody is different.
No, but from the sentiments in Rajendra Nagar or people feel that, this is the only goal in my life.
No. Right. I think they should be driven with that thought in their mind. But see, for example, there are 180 IAS this year. But those are not the only ones that deserve to be in IAS. There are many more. So I think that is the gist.
No, the only thing is that you should do your part, put in your 100% effort. Outcome is not in your hands. How things will turn out.
Similarly, there was prelims recently. Right. So I would suggest people who weren't able to qualify, please prepare for next year. And who are saturated, please find something good in the other sectors because they will find something good.
There is always something better to do.
Yes.
Anyway, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, sir.
Right, it was a great interaction.
Same here, sir. And also, I would like to thank you.
Right.
Personally, you have helped me a lot.
I think I'll briefly tell people that, you know, Yaksh was part of the HIT test series. It is a 5-test plan. I think Yaksh wrote one test part of it. We interacted once or twice, I believe. Arpit suggested Yaksh to the program.
And I wrote a lot of tests. I think your personal guidance and the best part about the test series is that it is very well crafted.
Right.
The questions are appropriate and you asked on the similar patterns.
Right.
So I think this is, as apart from all the test series that I've come across, it is very well crafted.
See, I think the program is very challenging.
Yes.
I keep telling my team that, you know, this week was fine. Next week, you can always screw up. So, you just make sure that we don't screw up.
Yes.
You don't have to do excellent work. You just have to do consistent work.
So, I think your personal guidance has also helped me a lot.
I think it will look like, you know, this has been done for that.
No.
The primary purpose of this interaction was to talk about preparation and different aspects of preparation. And thank you again so much for your time.
Thank you, sir.
All the things that you have sent.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.